Today, let's look at some advanced conversational AI concepts like collecting and analyzing data in post-call webhooks. Let's jump into a little demo here where we will collect information to design our very own conversational AI agent.
Hi, Thor. I'm Hope from the 11 Labs team. I'm here to help you design your very own conversational AI agent. To kick things off, let me know what kind of agent you're looking to create. For example, do you want a support agent to help your users answer questions, or a sales agent to sell your products, or just a friend to chat with?
Could I get a support agent to help with payments integrations?
Okay, so you're looking to create a support agent that specializes in helping users with payment integrations. Does that sound right? If so, are you ready to move on to the next step where you'll provide the knowledge base for your agent?
Yeah, let's do it.
Great. Now you'll need to create the agent's knowledge base. You can do this by uploading documents or submitting URLs to public websites that contain information your agent should know about payment integrations. Please let me know when you've provided everything you want the agent to know.
Yeah, it's all there.
Okay, great. Now let's talk about the voice you want your agent to have. Can you describe the kind of voice you're looking for? For example, you could say something like a professional, strong-spoken female voice with a slight British accent.
Yeah, that's perfect. Let's go with that.
Perfect. So we've collected all the necessary information to create your conversational AI agent. Now, all I need is your email address so we can notify you when the agent is ready.
Awesome. Our conversational AI agent is ready. Let's chat.
Hello, how can I help you today?
Oh, what can you do?
I am a support agent specializing in payment integrations. I can answer your questions related to this topic and provide helpful and informative responses. To better assist you, could you please tell me what specific information you're looking for regarding payment integrations?
How much payment volume did Stripe process in 2024?
Businesses using Stripe processed $1.4 trillion in total payment volume in 2024. Is there anything else I can help you with regarding Stripe's payment volume?
So, as you can see, you know, we uploaded the Stripe annual letter and our agent knows about all the details for that. Okay, so there were tons of cool things in here. First of all, our agent was able to navigate through the page. Then we were able to programmatically create both the voice for our agent as well as the agent itself, upload all the documents and websites as the knowledge base, and then using the post-call webhook, we created the agent, we attached the custom voice design, and we then sent the agent ID here to the user via email using Resend. Okay, let's dissect this a little bit because a lot of cool stuff happening in there. So first of all, let's jump into our agent configuration. So in this case, I've only enabled English, but we can enable tons of different voices, and these can also automatically change the language as needed. You can see here we're using a dynamic variable that we're feeding in. So in the beginning, I typed in my name, and then the agent can open the conversation with this first message where the name is inside. And then here in the system prompt, you can see that we're defining the different steps that we have. So we have the initial step where we're asking about, okay, what kind of agent are you looking to create? We have the training step where we upload all the necessary knowledge base documents and URLs. Then we have the voice design. So we're actually telling, the agent what voice we want our newly created agent to have. And then in the final step, we're collecting the user's email address, so once the agent is created and ready, we can send them the link to talk to their very own personal conversational AI agent. And so you can see here that we're always calling the setUI state when we're moving between steps. So we're just using Gemini 2.0 Flash here as the brain for our agent. This allows us to have very reliable tool calling in there. And then you can see here the tool we have is the set UI state. It is a client tool, and this is the tool that allows the agent to navigate between the steps. Okay, so this is all the configuration here. You can see we just set Hope as our agent voice, and that's pretty much it. We also have the security, we have authentication enabled. We will need to create a signed URL for our agent to then connect from the client side. Okay, so let's jump over into our code. So here we have a Next.js application that we're using to set up our agent and collect all the necessary information, and then also process the conversational AI webhook event. So you can see here that we're using the React client from the 11 Labs package, and here specifically the use conversation hook. So you can see here we have a couple of state variables where we're collecting our information from the form. And then we're just having our conversation here. We have some callback handlers here on connecting, disconnecting. So we're just logging out these different events. And then we're starting our conversation. So to start our conversation, we need to request access to the device here, the audio device. It's the microphone. And then we're getting a signed URL. Now, to get the signed URL, we have an API route here, which is called signed URL. This is using the 11 Labs client from the 11 Labs JavaScript SDK package with our 11 Labs agent ID. And then we're just calling the conversational AI get signed URL with our agent ID. And so that's what we're returning back. And then using the signed URL, we can then on the client side start our session with the conversational AI. And then what we're getting back is the conversational AI ID, which we will need to persist kind of the state throughout the conversation. And we will write that to the database later so that later in the post call webhook, we can get back the state for the agent and bring that all together. So here we're passing in the signed URL. Our dynamic variables is what we typed in at the start. So there we put in the username so that our agent can do that personalized greeting. And then we have our client tool here, which is the set UI state. And all this really does is it changes the state variable set current step to the relevant step that we are in. And that is very much it. We're then just setting our conversational ID in a state variable as well. And then we just have a couple more callback handlers, for example, handling the email submit. So that's just a form submit, and we want to stop the conversation. That's just what we're doing here. And then we're just adding the website fields, update fields, and so forth. So as we're submitting our form, what we then need to do is we need to upload all the files to use for our conversational AI agent. So here we just have a server-side action. We're using the new after function in Next.js to do kind of a background job here. And then we're also using Redis within Vercel to persist our state so we can retrieve it in the webhook handler. So here we're just setting up our 11 Labs client and then calling here the upload form data. So this is what our form is calling in the action for the form submit. So you can see here, we have our form action to be the upload form data. And so it is calling this, and then we can extract the form data from the form. So we have the file upload here, the text input, the email input, the URL input, and our conversation ID we're putting in as a hidden field. And then what we're doing is basically just looping through all our files that the user uploaded, and we're calling the 11 Labs client conversational AI add to knowledge base with the file. And so once that was successfully added to the knowledge base, then we're just pushing this entry here to an array of the knowledge base so that later we can write that into the database. The same we're doing for all the URLs that the user provides. So we're just adding them to the knowledge base and then adding them in to our state that will persist in the database. So here, lastly, we're just using the conversation ID as the key store for our Redis key value store here. So the conversation ID as the key, and then the email and the knowledge base we pass in into the database. And then we're just redirecting back to the success page. So you can see we're calling all these upload actions in the after handler. So that means actually we're being redirected to the success page immediately, while in the background we're uploading all the files to the knowledge base. Once that has happened, on the form submit, we're then stopping the conversation. So once that happens, the conversation is stopped, and then the data analysis part kicks in. So if we go back here to our configuration in the analysis section, you can see that we have a couple of things here that we want to evaluate. So first of all, we want to check if all the data was provided. So we're saying here, evaluate whether the user provided a description of the agent they are looking to generate, as well as a description of the voice. So these are the two pieces of information that we want to collect. And then here in the data collection, you can see we specify we want to pull out the voice description as a string, and we're prompting the LLM that based on the description of the voice the user wants the agent to have, generate a concise description of the voice, including, you know, age, accent, tone. So these are kind of the things that we can feed into our voice design to design a specific voice for this agent. And then the agent description, so based on the description about the agent the user is looking to design, generate a prompt that can be used to train a model to act as that agent. So this is the information that we need to actually create that conversational AI agent for the user. So now that we have all that information collected, we can dive into the webhook side of things. So in order to configure the webhook, here we need to create a new route. And you can see that I'm proxying my route through ngrok because it needs to be available on the open internet for 11 Labs to call the webhook. And so we can dive back into the configuration in the overall settings. So in conversational AI, we can go to the settings and we can here specify a post call webhook. And so we can create a new webhook. So here you can see in my case, we're using ngrok. So we provide our URL. And so once you provide the URL and the name and you create the webhook, you will get a webhook secret. And this webhook secret you need to set in your environment variables. So you can see here, there's a couple of things we need. This config AI webhook secret, API key, agent ID. And then also we're using resend and we're using upstash. So these are the variables that we need to provide to make this agent run. So once we have that, we can look at the route for the webhook. So we're initializing all our clients, our Redis client, our resend client, our 11 Labs client, and we're just, you know, get method just saying webhook is listening. So we can just verify that that works. And then here, the post is where the magic happens. So first of all, our secret we're getting from the environment variables. And then we have a method here, construct webhook event, which is taking in the next request as well as the secret. So it's reading out the raw body from the request here. And then we're getting out the signature header from the request. And we're just doing a bunch of verification here. So you can take this from the documentation. It's all documented in there to construct your webhook event. And so once we have our webhook event, we either get an event or an error. And so we can check if our event type is a post call transcription. So that is the event type once all the transcript and the analysis has been done. And then here we can get out the conversation ID, the analysis and the agent ID. So first of all, we can check that, you know, this is actually the webhook for our agent. So we're checking this against our 11 Labs agent ID. And then also we can check that this analysis evaluation criteria result, you saw we, you know, set this criteria that we want to check if all the data was provided, and we can check if that was successful. So now that we know all the data has been provided, we can go and we can design the voice. And so we're getting out our voice preview. We're creating that with the text to voice create previews, and then we're using the data collection result with the value of the voice description to create that. And then in our case here, you know, because we don't have any user interaction, this is happening in the webhook, we're just taking the first preview and we are generating the voice from the preview to set our voice. So this here, we get our voice ID. And then what we need to do is we need to get our data from Redis using the conversation ID. So then we have our Redis data. And now what we can do is we can create the, you know, custom conversational AI agent for our user. So, you know, imagine we're a platform creating conversational AI agents for our users. That is exactly what we can do here using the 11 Labs client. With conversational AI, we want to create an agent. We're just calling it agent for conversation, you know, with this ID. We're setting the text-to-speech configuration to have the voice ID that we just generated, that we just designed. And then we're putting in the agent prompt. So the agent prompt is just our agent description that we gotten from the data collection. And then as well as our knowledge base. So our knowledge base is this array that, you know, previously as we were uploading the documents, we were just storing all the knowledge base IDs in an array. So we're passing that in here. And then for the first message, we're just setting, hello, how can I help you today? And so once that was successful, we just have now our agent created. And so now we can send an email to our agent. So here I was just using new.email to create this email template. So you can see here new.email, really cool service from Resend. I basically just put in, you know, with a prompt what I want, and I got out my custom email. And so I put that template in here, and I basically just passing in the agent ID as a prop, and then just linking to the talk to agent, to the hosted agent page from 11 Labs. And that is pretty much it. We're just with that sending our recent email, and then the user gets the email and can chat to the agent. We can now also see on our dashboard, this agent for our conversation was created. We can see that it has the custom voice that we created.
The night air carried whispers of betrayal, thick as London fog.
So that was our strong female professional voice with a slight British accent. You can see for the agent here, the first message that was sent through the API. And then you say here, a support agent specializing in payment integrations. That's very good. We're just using the default Gemini 2.0 Flash. And you can see here as the knowledge base, we have the PDF that the user uploaded, as well as the how payment intents work, the scraped information of that website made available to the agents. There we are. This is how we can programmatically create conversational AI agents in post-call webhooks. Really, really cool, really advanced functionality here. And I'm very excited to see what you all will build. Let us know in the comments below or on Twitter what you are working on. We'd love to hear from you. And I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.